very good morning. You're watching Proactive London. Dr. Zvi Marom from BATM Advanced Communications joins us. Dr. Marom, very good to see you this morning.
Thank you. Very good to see you, Chris.
So just take us through then. We've got a few things to unpack today. The first half numbers you've released, the H1 numbers from BATM, a little bit nuanced, I think. Can you walk us through some of those numbers from the first half of the year, please?
Yes. I will give you the highlights. The networking division has done very well. We have also the biggest backlog ever, but as you know, there is a components shortage worldwide, so it's starting to untangle, but slowly. So we are producing as fast as our legs carry us, and there is a good results, the cyber as well. Obviously, the demand for cyber, especially from government defense agencies, is growing in light of what is happening in the world, etc. On the diagnostic sides, on this, we have three units. The unit of the ECOMED is doing well. The distribution is doing well. The production has not achieved the results. And the main reason is that we have seen that Corona basically disappeared. We have good backlog of other infectious diseases that have been our core competency, and we are supplying. So we believe that H2 will be strong. In all the division, we are involved in large-scale bids. We believe that some of them will end in our favor. With no exception with all of them, we are showing technological superiority, and these have been our focal strength. So I believe things will happen in the coming months, in September, maybe in October. Except of that, of course, we have to fight with two situations. Which is, one is the decline of the European currencies and the pound versus the dollar. We report in dollar. Bottom line, it almost did not affect us, very little, because we hedge ourselves in the expenses versus the income. So it doesn't affect us. But on the upper line, when we report in dollars, obviously when we get lots of euros, pounds, etc., it's less dollars in the balance sheet. So it doesn't affect so much the profit, but it does affect the upper line. And last but not least is the war between Russia and Ukraine. Both Russia and Ukraine have been our good customers. Obviously, with Russia, the situation is more complicated, but I have to say that now Ukraine is coming back to the situation of the pre-war after 4 months that we had to sort out which way we actually deal with the logistics. So overall, in my past, until 2021, I was the chairman of the Israeli IT Association. I said, I don't want to be a unicorn. I want to be a high-tech camel, one that can go in the desert for a very long time. I think we demonstrated it very well in the confused times that we are. Despite all the things that I described, we are in very good position now. And I think we will have a good H2 and also good next year.
Well, I say the unicorn camel analogy is a very interesting one. BATM also offloaded a business. How did that impact your performance?
Well, we offloaded a business that started as a software house for ourselves, NGSoft. It grew over the years. It grew far larger than we anticipated. It started to give services to several customers. And in the end, we came to the conclusion that we better sell it. We sold it to the guys that distribute Microsoft in Israel. It was very complementary for them. And we came to the conclusion that if we need services, we can buy it from them instead of managing a company with a lot of HR and so on and so on. This is not our core competency. We got a very good deal. The guys, the fund that bought it from us, is very, very happy, and they are looking for more deals. let's see where the future will bring us.
You've touched on a lot of points I was going to pick up on then in what you've been saying already. Are there any plans to make bolt-on acquisitions, or are you focused on organic expansion?
First, we have good organic expansion, a very, very good organic expansion. And so far, this has been the results have been the result of this organic expansion. But as we look now, the decline in the euro value, for example, gives us a good opportunity with some of our partners. For example, in the networking side, our sales is growing mainly in the United States, dollars, and we are seeing some partners. I don't do acquisitions of people that I don't know and I don't work with for quite some time, because otherwise it's a prescription for failure. And we are not big enough to afford failures in mergers and acquisitions. So the situation overall gives us opportunities. And we are looking on them all the time, but I want to be sure that when we do such a M&A, it at least in the long term gives a good value to the shareholders. I will give an example. The Engisoft, I bought it from Israel's government, the energy committee. They were on the edge of bankruptcy. We bought them for $250,000, and 11 years later we sold them for $30 million. So that's a good example. But you need patience. You need to know who you are buying. You have to see that the culture is similar between the companies. So we have few targets. We are looking on them. We are talking to them. Let's see, in the near future, things will happen, to my opinion, within a year time frame.
Well, it sounds like you're confident going forward for the rest of the year. And of course, we wish you the best of luck and hope you'll keep us updated of any more developments over there at BATM. In the meantime, Dr. Zvi Marom from BATM Advanced Communications, thanks for your time today at Proactive London.
Thank you very much. Thank you.